Hey, what's up guys, it's L4w3s here, and this is my one of possibly four videos. It may possibly not be. Based on the time I'm recording this at, it's probably only going to be two, which is Minecraft, along with the special one I sort of said to you on Friday. Well, in the description anyway, I didn't say it in the video, but in the description I said I have a surprise for you. Now, this surprise is going to be a game, a sequel rather, actually. It's not the surprise I wanted to give you, but it's going to be the sequel to the game that I was going to give you. The game I was going to give you is called The Longest Journey. It's a very old game, and because it uses an extremely old version of Install Shield, I think it is, or something like that, it uses a very old version of the setup file, and because Windows 7, the one I'm using at the moment, isn't compatible with this file, or rather this file isn't compatible with Windows 7, because it's not used so much anymore. They've updated and they don't use these files anymore, so these files were never, you know, the files I suppose needed for this program were never ever used anymore, so they were never ever actually put into Windows 7. But I recently found out about SQL, so to give that one a shot. So I did, and I quite liked it, so I decided, why not? I'm just going to put this up on there, instead of, you know, the first one, which I've actually been trying to spend almost all day today, which is Saturday. I'm recording this at 1:27 in the morning, Sunday, but spent almost all day Saturday trying to figure out how to get this game working, because I really wanted to record this. I really wanted to play it, really. You know, regardless of recording, I really want to play it, because it's such a good game. I enjoyed it when I played it before, and I really want to play a game. But I was unsuccessful. But I found the second one, and I enjoyed that, so I decided to give that a shot. And like I said, I enjoyed it. So I figured, why not? I used this to replace the first one. So I did. And I'm going to record that after this. Now this video is just a tour, I guess you could say, of my single player world. I can't remember if I did one recently. I didn't. I just remembered. The very first video of Freaky Friday was the redstone one, the furnace trapdoor. That was done on the ground of this world when I literally didn't even have this building. It was the staircase. I think I only had the staircase along with the first building, and that was originally my central hub, whereas this is now where I am now, where I will start all my videos, up here that is anyway. Basically, what I want to show you though, this is, like I said, this is a tour, and I will be showing you my single player world. So you get a tour of my single player world in Minecraft, along with this video, this sequel of The Longest Journey, which is called Dreamfall, I believe. Dreamfall, The Longest Journey. It's a brilliant game, from what I've gained. I've only played about 10 minutes of it, but probably not even that. I played it for 10 minutes or so, and the gameplay, I've only played, like, I don't know, like 2 minutes of gameplay over the span of 10 minutes, because I actually got The Longest Journey from my dad, because he was really into that game. Along with the new one, you know, the newest one, the sequel, and he passed it down to me, and me and him were spent pretty much the whole of Saturday trying to figure out how to get it to work, and it wouldn't work. But anyway, yeah, on with this video, because that's what this video is, this video. Okay, as you may have noticed, I've got redstone lamps in the floor. You may not know that. You know, some of you who aren't used to this texture pack may not know that these are redstone lamps, but they are. Basically, if I just hit the power button, you see it lights up, and it's a little, the sort of response is a little laggy. It's okay, it's really not doing what it should be doing, but it should be, it did, oh my god, it's doing the same thing it did before. Okay, basically what I did before was I tried to do a recording just now, but I literally have hardly any space on my hard drive, so I've just plugged an external hard drive, of course, straight to this. Anyway, back to the video. This should be going in a cycle around, stopping here and starting here. It starts here and goes around. I think it's a 5 blocks sort of chain, I guess you could say, with it what should be, I think, 3 blocks in between, but because it's lagging a bit, it's not. I think it's either 2 or 3 blocks in between. I'm not entirely sure, but it was working fine the other day, actually, which is why I'm a bit concerned for it now. Anyway, leave that. Oh, no. Anyway, then we've got the furnace, which is a fireplace. It's just going to be a fireplace, and I did kind of cheat this in, cause otherwise it wouldn't always be on. I'm not actually burning anything inside it. I'll just show you. It's got nothing in it. And by the way, everything in my inventory is from the previous recording. I made leather trousers and leather cap in the previous recording. This chainmail chest plate was gained on the zombie survival, along with the iron sword, which was, at the beginning of previous recording, completely full in durability, whereas now it's almost completely drained. This was from the very first video I did, which I recently enchanted and creative. The redstone stuff is all from redstone stuff, along with the second line up here, is all from the first one as well. I think the chest is also from the first one, along with the redstone. Flint and steel, bow, and golden apple are all from the zombie survival, and everything else you see from this is from my last recording, which failed. But back to the tour. Like I showed you, the floor, the fireplace, and one of my favourite things in this whole entire area is this. This sort of log, this jungle log. This is a jungle log and jungle leaves. Now, I love this. It's like a little plant thing. You may have already gained that. May have already guessed that, sorry. But, yeah, it's just like, I don't know, I love it. I don't know why. I just do. Quite like it. But yeah, there's those in all four corners. You'll see those in a few of the buildings. What else? Red seats. I do enjoy these. I do like these red seats as well. Although, what kind of, I don't know, I kind of wish they had sort of red signs. I may ask my good friend Thomas to help me with that one. Ud98. I will link his channel in the description. Because I haven't mentioned him. No, but check him out. He's an awesome guy. He's got good videos. But yeah. He also does texture packs. He textures. So yeah. Might see if I can get him to texture me to science. Or actually, no. I might see there's a mod out there for multiple types of science, which I might get him to texture one of those for me once I get that. But yeah. Back to the video. I keep going off. I'm sorry. Got two chests here. This is full of stuff from Zombie Survival. Yeah, I kind of have nicked some stuff from this. Iron sword, I believe. Chest plate, the chain chest plate, and the flint and steel. Everything else in here is from Zombie Survival, apart from these. I believe these are from before, actually, when I was actually making the place. After the Freaky Friday, the furnace trapdoor one. Anyway, these are the remains from the furnace trapdoor video. You may have, can't speak. But yeah, those are the remains in that chest. A bit of wiring back there, so you can see it's a bit lumpy, bumpy out there. But it kind of has to be for the flooring. But I like it. It adds a bit of a, makes it look kind of special. I don't know. Looks fine. Okay. Not only is it going to be like a tour, but it's going to be like directional guide, I should say. Okay, so we follow this path. We turn right. Now we'll go straight on, but I'm turning right because this is one of my favorite places, Da Club. First of all, let me just show you quickly. We just came out of crib. Now we're about to enter that club, the club here. 5 jukeboxes in the four in the corners, nothing in any of them. I've actually ran through this in my previous video. I want to check out to see if there's actually anything in them. Nope, nothing in any of these jukeboxes. Did I check center? Nothing. But, note blocks here. Note blocks there. Okay. Also, you may notice the game is fairly quiet compared to usual on my videos. That would be because of what's next going to come up in a minute. I'll actually explain that in a minute. But, basically, we entered the club through the front entrance, I like to call this, because compared to the other two, it is the front. So, you know, we're coming through the front. This would be the left exit, or left entrance, along with this being the right exit, or right entrance, depends on how you like to say it. So, yeah, I don't know. Basically, we're going to go through the right first. We're going to go straight up ahead, and we come in front of the greens. Now, not very green, I know, apart from when they're growing. And I'm actually going to do some collecting now, like I did in the previous video. I'm just going to get the seeds. So that's how long I've been not recording for. Sorting out the issues with my computer. But we're just going to collect these. I did that before as well. Well, so did my chicken, actually. Chicken did that. Anyway, we have our greens. This is the greens. So, yeah, we grow all our crops here. And what I was going to put in this room before, which I did, but then I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but the save file kind of got a bit, well, my game sort of crashed and all is dodgy, I don't know why. It went dodgy and it just crashed on me and didn't save half of my map. But basically, what I wanted to do was, what I did, but I'm going to do again, is around this, okay, well there's, as you may see, there's glowstone in the floor, along with in the roof, in the ceiling kind of thing. And what my main plan was that I have these glowstones around here, in a sort of, I guess, say that actually, if you look at it without this one, this one, this one, and this one, it's actually 9x9. Sorry, 3x3. You've got 3 across the top, 3 across the middle, and then you've got your 1, 2, 3 across the bottom, and then you've got your little central pack, the central square here. Basically, around this center block, I was going to have sort of dirt, and then I was going to have pumpkins along making L shape. For those of you who play chess or know this chess, you know, the knight can jump, move in an L shape. Now, I was going to do that, that exact shape, two of those shapes actually, with melons, like one side, and then, like, you know, so it's like melon, 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 and then pumpkin, 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 and that didn't quite work. Well, it worked, but it didn't save. Also, every, you know, every few blocks around here, I might have some grass just to add the green to it. I guess you could say, oh, lag a bit there. Why not? But yeah, as you also may have noticed, we've got a grass patch here, which is caused by a stupid chicken. This one over here, I think, caused by me just now, actually. Actually, no. I lie. This one here was caused by stupid me trying to chase after, well, trying to get back from a stupid chicken. This one was done by the stupid chicken. And this little space here, where there should be a glass plane, which I need to fix, was caused by me trying to kill a chicken in the corner, which wouldn't really die. But yeah, that's basically the greens. Now we're moving on to slaughterhouse. This is where all my mobs are usually kept, but they're not at the moment. And In the previous video, I actually went along and slaughtered them all, whereas I'm not doing that now, because I'm not spawning them back in. That was a pain, getting rid of them all. But the chickens were in this one, which was a humongous pain, because like I said, they got caught in there, and I kind of had to smash the glass to get to them, and they fell down and trampled my crops. That was them. Then we have, in here, I believe was cows, and these weren't really, these were not a trouble to kill, along with the pigs, which are here, which were here rather. And like I said earlier, you may have noticed my sound is turned down a bit, and that was because the mobs are extremely loud, and I had to turn my volume down during that recording. Now, as you may have noticed, in here, we have sheep. Now, the reason I have not killed these is because I need to get myself shears, so I can shear the, what do you wanna call that, sorry for yawning so much, it's kind of like late, you know, in the morning. Yeah, sorry, but, I need to shear the wool off their backs, that's the one. How could I not get that? I don't know. But they're still alive. You think you're wool. The stuff I sleep on. Anyway. Yeah, so that's the greens and the slaughterhouse. But my next one would be coming in from the right and going out to the left. Basically, we're coming from the front, actually, and we go left. Close the door behind me. We go left. Ooh. Go left. Now, I'm just going to follow what I did before, and I'm going to go straight on. This should be the hot room, which I'll be renaming Smelter soon, the Smelter Room, or the Burner Room. Something like that. But this is the hot room. It is furnaces. Now we have three chests in here, just for quick storage, whenever we need it. I'm just going to move all this in here again. Just move it into my inventory. Basically in here we have furnaces. That's it. Okay, when we leave the hot room, I guess you could say, we would come straight down here and rather ignore me when I say leave the hot room. We're actually going to come from the club again. The club, we're coming from the left exit, or left entrance, however you want to say it. Instead of going straight on to the hot room, we go left. Now I'm going to ignore all turns. Just go straight on. I think there's three turns. No, just two? Okay. I can't remember, I didn't count. I've lost it. This is the bullet room. Now this is crafting tables. Again, you've got your three storage crates, oh my god. Three storage chests, rather. Along with a room full of crafting tables. Now, this one is called Build It, and I will be renaming the hot one, like I said, to Burn It or Smelt It or something like that. We will see next time. But anyway, right now, I'm going to go back to the club. Now, like before, we're going to come out from the left entrance or exit of the club. We've just left. We're going to turn left again. Now, we're going to go around in a circle here, because if I go left here and just go straight on and ignore all turns, we find ourselves at the crib. But then again, if I do want to do a proper circle, I just go left again, and we find myself at the club again. Now, if I go straight on from the club's front exit, or if we're coming from the crib, we go left, we will find ourselves at Power Room. Now, this is just literally, you may have guessed already, if you haven't, you will see we are going around the bookcases, and boom, we have a room. Oh, wow, I have a chest in here, I didn't even know that. I didn't even know there was diamond stuff in here. I blame Jesse. He was the one in charge of placing stuff. I'm going to take that. I won't use this, don't worry. This will all be placed inside my chest back at home, I guess you could say. I'm also going to take this chest with me as well. Where did it go? Did I take it? I did. Okay. This is an enchanting room. You can see it's... I'm not sure it's getting full. I'm not sure entirely it's getting full, sort of, power, I guess you could say, but it's certainly getting something. This is enough to give me a very high level item. This was this diamond pickaxe, efficiency 3, unbreaking 3, was a 47. I'm not entirely sure, based off memory. I think that's it. But okay, before we go through there, I just want to remind you that the crib's on the right up here. That way, and that's the club, and we were just entering the power room. Now if we go through the power room, all the way across here, and we come in here, through here, close the door, we go straight on, and we ignore all turns, we find ourselves at the stairwell. Now this stairwell, I will not go all the way down, don't worry. The stairwell is humongous. It's extremely long. I'm not going to go all the way down. I'm just going to go as far as I need to give you some information about what's to come up soon. Something that is a work in progress. Where is it? Here it is. Okay. Mining station. Now, this is bedrock. This block here is bedrock. It will not break. No matter how many times I hit it with my dumb pickaxe, it will not break. It's bedrock. Okay. Mining station. I blocked it off for now because I don't want you guys to see it, but mainly because it's probably 0.01% complete. But what I want from the mining station is to have a huge block of cobblestone, or rather a huge block of what looks like bedrock, which is actually going to have cobblestone inside it. It's going to be a cobblestone block full of ores, which is encased in bedrock, so you can't get out and you can't get in. But I will obviously be removing this once it's fully complete and replace it with a door and an entrance. But what I'm going to have is I'm going to have a humongous sort of block with every ore in the game. And what I know you may think, well, you placed it there, you know where it's all going to be, that's cheating. Whereas, you know, let's be honest here, who in the world is going to remember where they placed every single block of diamond, every single block of gold, iron, coal, lapis, redstone, everything, you know, stone, I'll be honest, I'm probably not going to remember much of it. I can remember what I placed so far, but the amount of time it's going to take for me to complete this whole block, because it's going to be handmade, all of it. I mean, I'm not going to mine every mineral for it, but elsewhere. But I'm going to cheat the blocks in. It's just I'm going to place the blocks myself. There's no world edit involved. Actually, I lie. There will be world edit involved, but that's only to build like the base and the best, only to encase it. Whereas the ores will be placed randomly in random locations and in random, some on their own, some in. I think it's veins. I completely forgot what it's called. But some in bunches and groups. But yeah, that's the mining station. It's not actually, gone anywhere yet, obviously. But now we're going to go back up. This way, I believe it is, facing this way. We will see. But anyway, that's the stairwell. And it goes down extremely far, and as you can see down there, that is what I've got so far of the mining station, along with that, so you can just about see it. And you can see it goes off that way, and it also, actually, that's a point. That's not the full thing. Okay, that's not gone all the way off. I'm going to check that out now, actually. Actually, no, I won't. Okay, sorry for stirring off, but here's the power room. Like I said, straight on the stairwell. We'll go left from the power room. This is an extremely long one, and if we just follow this as well, hang on. This is the build-up room which you've already been in. I'm just going to quickly check something. Sorry for being pushed offside like this, but I just want to go off through the corner, because I know you can see stuff through the corner. Okay, just checking to see if it does extend further than I thought it did. Well, it must be my render distance just playing up. Anyway, Okay, so we've got the stairwell there, we've got the power room here. I'm just trying to think, is that it? Can't be it. I think I covered everything. Ah, no, they're not. I haven't. Okay. I'm just trying to see if I can find a recognisable place. This will do. The club. Okay, we're coming through the front entrance. We're going to exit through the left exit. We're going to go straight on, but instead of going straight on, we're actually going to go left, actually. And we've done a left here, we've done a straight on, but we haven't done a right. What's right, I wonder? The only room that's left is box full of items, storage. Now, all of these chests are empty as far as I know, so none of them are in use yet. But this is where storage will be when it comes to the point of storage. Also, there's something else I want to talk about as well with this room and every other room involved. First of all, I just want to say I love these plants. The jungle log along with the top. Love it. Okay. Now, this sort of room design, I'm looking at the ceiling mainly, but, you know, the whole room. The planks on the floor, along with a basic layout of stuff, like along the sides with the center being taken up. But mainly the materials used to build it, I guess you could say. As you can see, it's plank. This is a plank here. The whole floor is a plank. Then you've got a log as the one layer up, I guess you could say, as a one layer wall around the edges. And then it goes up in the corners as well to the top. Then you've got two blocks of glass panes, or I think they're called glass panes, I'm not entirely sure. I don't pay much attention to names, I just go for the blocks themselves, the blocks and items. These are two blocks tall, and then you've got the ceiling, the roof, if you will. Now, these are the same logs as these, and this. But what I like about the ceiling the most is the glowstones. As you can see, I don't want to hit too hard, do I? Glowstone in the corner. In every corner of every room, with the centerpiece in every single room as well, except from the greens room, which I told you had it in the floor. Now, what I've been thinking is, I sort of dislike torches. I don't know why. I just have this sort of semi hate for torches. I mean, I like them. It's just I prefer glowstone or lamps, which is why I was thinking. I want your input on this, by the way, guys. I want you to leave a comment and tell me whether I should do this or not. I mean, it's up to you. This is my YouTube world, after all, you know. I've named it YouTube. I only use this world for YouTube. But I want you guys to tell me if you'd like me to replace all of the the glowstone in the ceiling, in the roof, with lamps, with a switch. But of course, you must remember, this will require a box outside the room for wiring and such. So you must remember that. It will become a little more ugly, but it'll be pretty cool because you have a light switch. But actually, no, it probably won't take that much. It'll probably only take this section here. Oh no, I can't use this kind of... Well, I probably could. I could probably stick the light switch here, actually. And it'll probably take up it'll probably take up this whole corner and then the top. So the roof will be high and it'll be like three blocks high, probably. Which isn't that bad, or probably four. We'll see. But anyway, would you prefer I switch all of the glowstone in every single room? And that does include, where is it? I don't think it's visible from here. But I'll tell you what, I'll walk my way over there now, actually. It does include the greens room. And that includes the floor. Now, if you want, is this crib? Yeah, it's crib. Okay, club. See, I already know my sort of navigation. Okay, what I can do is what I may possibly be able to do, rather. I might be able to, don't know. We'll see. I might get Tom involved, because he's good with redstone as well as textures and stuff. But I can see if I can replace these glowstone blocks along with the ceiling ones, the roof ones, with lamps, like I said. If you want me to, leave that in the comments. And also, because I have my sort of semi-dislike, I mean, I don't mind them being here, but personally, I don't know, it kind of bothers me, but I won't move them if you don't want me to, but basically what I was thinking was glowstone path along the center, so like in place of these wooden planks here, we stick some glowstone or along the sides. I mean, I would cheat these in, or I would create a nether portal in the cave that I'm making downstairs in mining, the mining station. Sorry about that, guys. Yeah, like I was saying, the glowstone, which if you want me to, I can obtain, legitimately or legitimately, or I can cheat them in. It's up to you guys. But you know, tell me what you think on the comment in the comments, like lamp ceiling, lamp roofs in the greens, lamp floors as well, along with the glowstone across the floor. You let me know about that one. So yeah, just leave those two separate things in the comments. And I think that would do for the tour. We've got the enchantments, we've got main place, you've got the slaughterhouse, we've got the greens, we've got the builder, we've got hot room, which just seems to be smelter or burner. Down here we have, I think this is smelter or burner, isn't it? Is that? Builder, that's right. And there's the stairwell. I think that's it, everyone. If I find anything else after I've started recording, I will be sure to add it on to the end. But until then, I think that's it. Yeah, box of lightings. Yeah, I'm going to return back to the crib if I can remember where it is. I went the wrong way. Here we go. And we will end it just here. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, this is running a bit better, isn't it? I guess. Anyway. Like I said, thank you for watching, guys, and, yeah, if you're watching this before my other video, then good for you, because that's the order I recorded it in. Minecraft first, as always. Surprise, well, not so much of a surprise now, I kind of told you, in that Dreamfall second. So, thanks for watching, guys. Goodbye.